Einen schönen guten Abend und herzlich willkommen in die Elbphilharmonie, eine besondere Location für einen besonderen Anlass, der erste Telekom Street Gig Classic. Ich freue mich sehr drauf. Ich bin Sarah Willis und ich freue mich, mit Ihnen diesen Abend zu verbringen. Aber wir sind nicht ganz unter uns. Wir streamen gerade live auf der ganzen Welt auf Magenta TV und deswegen wird es jetzt auf Englisch gewechselt. I hope that's okay with you. Good evening, everybody. All the viewers at home on Magenta TV. Welcome to the Elbphilharmonie, a perfect location for tonight's very special occasion, concert, the first Telekom Street Gig Classical. I'm Sarah Willis, and my day job is to play the French horn in the Berlin Philharmonic Orchestra, but I love communicating my passion for classical music, and I love finding out about new things, and that's why tonight is perfect. Behind me is the wonderful Beethoven Orchestra Bonn. It's their first time playing here in the Elbphilharmonie. Herzlich willkommen. And they and their chief conductor, Dirk Kaftan, are performing three pieces for tonight's concert. After the interval, you'll be hearing one of the best loved pieces of classical music, Dvorak, Antonín Dvorak, the Czech composer's Ninth Symphony, called From the New World. Before the interval, something completely different, the Russian composer Dmitri Shostakovich's first piano concerto with the fiery Venezuelan virtuoso Gabriela Montero. There's also a second soloist in this piano concerto, a trumpet virtuoso called Simon Hörfler, who's one of Germany's up-and-coming great trumpet players. And why there's a trumpet soloist in a piano concerto, we'll explain to you later. But to start our concert, we have a very special event. The composer Ludwig van Beethoven had his 250th birthday last year. And to celebrate it all around the world, there were concerts, there were films, there were documentaries, there were remixes, you name it, they Beethovened it. But one of the most exciting projects to come out of his birthday celebrations is what you're going to hear tonight. Together with the Deutsche Telekom, a group of musicologists and scientists have programmed artificial intelligence to complete from the sketches of what Beethoven wrote, which would have been his 10th symphony. The piece had its premiere a couple of weeks ago in Bonn with the Beethoven Orchestra Bonn, and it was met with mixed reviews. Some were ecstatic and some were a bit reserved, but that's normal. In the times of Beethoven, he was such a revolutionary that his music was also received at premieres, sometimes a little reserved and critical almost. But this piece raises big questions. Can algorithms be creative? Can a machine create music to stir our emotions? Because that's what music is all about. It's about raising our emotions and making us feel something. Now, I think that listening to music, especially classical music, it's a very individual thing, and it's a wonderful thing because it's a different experience for each one of us. There are no rules, there's no right or wrong of how to enjoy a piece. So I hope you'll just sit back, enjoy this Beethoven, how it's completed. We don't know what Beethoven would have thought of it. It's just one way of how the symphony could have been finished. It's a fascinating experiment. Please enjoy. And now welcome to the stage, the principal conductor of the Beethoven Bonn Orchestra, Dirk Kaftan, and tonight's first soloist on the organ, Karen Carpenter. Viel Spaß.
Thank you. Thank you.
So was denken Sie? What do you think? Did you enjoy it? They enjoyed it a lot. Good, I'm really happy to hear that. Now, I'm going to ask, it's unusual for the soloist of a piece to come out before she plays, but because we have a little time when the piano's being rolled on, I've asked Gabriela to come out and tell us a little bit about the Shostakovich, because she knows a lot more than me. Gabriela Montero, welcome. Bienvenidas. It's so great to have you here in the Elbphilharmonie. It's an amazing place, isn't it?
It's a beautiful place. It's, well, iconic at this point.
Absolutely. Yeah. And we wanted to ask about the Shostakovich, because I mentioned at the beginning that it almost became a trumpet concerto, and then I would have been talking with Simon and not with you. So what actually happened there with this piece? Why is there another soloist?
Well, of course, Shostakovich was a pianist, so he wrote something that he wanted to play himself. And thank God that it was made for the piano, because it's such a fantastic piece with this, you know, sardonic, brutal humor, and at the same time, this sadness and oppression and weight and absurdity of this music and of the times as well.
What sort of a space was Shostakovich in when he composed this? Because he was getting a lot of resistance from the system, something you as a Venezuelan really know about and can relate to.
Absolutely. I mean, for an artist, it's very difficult when you don't have freedom to express and to comment on what's going on around you. So I think he felt that the only way he could do it was through clues in the music and through portraying these kinds of, you know, absurd, grotesque situations and feelings that were happening, you know, that were being felt in at the time. Stalin, of course, was persecuting everyone. Everyone felt suffocated. And this is very much what you hear in this piece.
The trumpet, I find, also works as like a commentator. Mm-hmm. You know, you're playing and the trumpet is going tack, 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 and really sort of getting in there and saying his opinion.
Yeah, it's kind of that voice that says, you know, this kind of oppressive little finger that's always there, saying you can't do that, and sometimes with humor, though.
You've composed, she's not only an amazing piano player, she's also a great composer. And your piece, Expatria, reminded me of Shostakovich's music, because it's in the same sort of situation. You felt you had to make a stand and let your voice be heard through music.
Well, thank you for asking about that. I wrote Expatria in 2011 to portray in music and sound, which is so direct to the heart of everybody and anywhere in the world, to portray the situation in Venezuela that has been happening in the last 21 years, the collapse, the devastation of an entire country and an entire people. And I realized that I could tell the story of Venezuela in words, but it was much more effective if I did it through sound and through metaphor, because everybody understands what that sounds like and that feels like. It doesn't matter where you're from. So that's, I think, very much aligned with what Shostakovich was trying to do in his time.
I absolutely agree. So if there's somebody here who's listening to the piece for the first time, what should they listen out to? As a horn player, of course, the piano part's great, but I listen out to also for the trumpet. He's got some incredibly different things. Simon Hörfler is such a wonderful trumpet player.
Yeah.
And you'll hear his fanfares, his double tonguing is... you'll hear that a lot, especially at the end. What would you say that the audience can listen out for if someone hasn't heard the piece before?
Well, first of all, you'll see me going completely mad at the piano, because this is what you have to be. You have to be in a state of madness and complete, you know, paranoia and persecution. And sometimes when you feel like that, all you can do is throw your arms up in the air and say, life is so absurd. My life is so absurd. So you'll hear this kind of crazy edge all the time. And at the same time, second movement, you'll hear music that is so desolate and it's so heartbreaking that it really, really, you know, pulls at your heartstrings.
Thank you. Yeah. I know it's a big thing to get a soloist out to speak before a performance. You've got to get all the way around.
Thank you
so much for speaking
to
us. Toy,
pleasure.
Go and find Simon and Dirk.
Bye-bye.
Gabriela Montero. It's always a big treat to hear what the artists think and how they relate to the music. So now we're going to hear Shostakovich's first piano concerto with the soloist Gabriela Montero and the trumpet soloist Simon Hörfler, played by the Beethoven Orchestra Bonn, conducted by Dirk Kaftan. Viel Spaß, enjoy.
Thank you very much, and bravo to this wonderful orchestra and to Dirk Kaftan. And it's a pleasure to be here. And I'm going to do something now that I have done always since I was a little girl. I'm going to improvise something for you. And for this, I always ask, you know, for a theme from the public so that I can use it in my improvisation. I play it a few times to remember. And then something happens that will never happen again. So I'm going to do two improvisations. And for this, I need someone to sing me a theme, something that is well known and recognizable. And then I'll play it a few times, and then we see what happens. There's nothing planned. So would someone like to give me a theme to improvise on? Anything at all? Something that everybody will know? Maybe I can do that for the second one. For the second one. Okay, good, good. And you had something there? Okay, okay. Do you all want to sing this to me? Because I don't know German songs. So, and I know that Reeperbahn is German. So, yes. It's worse. Okay. Okay. Okay, I can see you did not practice, okay? So let's see. Sing it again to me. Just you. Yeah, so... Okay, so what you said, okay? Okay, thank you. So I'll just use that little part. Thank you. Thank you.
Willkommen zurück. Welcome back. So we began this concert with music from the new world, from our new world, man and machine making music together. And we're finishing this concert with music from the new world as well, but another new world. Antonín Dvořák, the Czech composer, went to America in the 1890s to take up a teaching position. And he fell in love with the music, the folk songs, the spirituals, and he put this into his Ninth Symphony, which we're about to hear. He was also very homesick, and you can feel that in the music. There's some beautifully homesick tunes in there for us to hear tonight. As a horn player, this is a piece I could play over and over again, and I just don't get tired of it. The same as when I listen to it. I promised you one of classical music's best beloved pieces, and this is really it tonight. And there are a few things to look out for. The horns, playing the theme of the first movement, which comes again and again. I may be biased, but of course, I have to mention the horns. The English horn, which is not a horn, it's not a horn that's English, it's part of the oboe family. The English horn is a large oboe playing the beautiful, well-known melody of the second movement, where you can really hear this longing and this coming home that Dvořák put into the music. And I also want you to pay attention to the tuba, because the tuba has 13 notes, 14 notes. One is tied over in the whole piece. So please watch out and make sure you can see where he plays them. Yeah, they're very important. So to end our concert, Dvořák's Ninth Symphony from the New World, conducted by Dirk Kaftan, played by the Beethoven Bonn Orchestra. Welcome back, Dirk. Viel Spaß. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
What a fantastic concert. Are you clapping as loudly as home at home as they are here in the hall? It was absolutely amazing. We're hoping that there'll be another Telecom Street Gig Classical before too long. Thank you very much for watching. And if you want to watch again or get all your friends to watch, Jenny, come and tell me, how do our viewers get to watch it?
You can rewatch the whole concert at magentamusic360.de or on Magenta TV.
And how do you say goodbye in Hamburg? Is a special way.
In Hamburg, sagt man tschüss.
So, I'd say tschüss. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.